the real magic with the stellate ganglion block and PTSD is that it allows patients the opportunity to address the hard stuff in their counseling sessions, in their therapy sessions, without having really large triggers. All right, so for our only procedure for today is the stellate ganglion block. If you watched last week's episode of Friday's at RP, I don't know, Mark, if you can kind of link that here. But we did a stellate ganglion block, but that the one that we did last week was more for unilateral vascular migraines, which to touch base on that, the patient has only had one headache last week and no migraine, which is a huge, huge improvement from the frequency that she was having them before. And so that is obviously gonna be beneficial for her moving forward. So today, our stellate ganglion block is gonna be done for a patient who has some mild traumatic experiences throughout their childhood and teen years, and that has resulted in some generalized anxiety that plagues the patient every single day. And so this is actually our second stellate ganglion block on this patient. The first one was done about 2 weeks ago. Generally, what we found clinically is that when we do two stellate ganglion blocks in the period of about 7 to 14 days, depending on scheduling and the patient, things like that, we get a stronger synergistic effect, because that first stellate ganglion block is going to really reduce that sympathetic outflow. And then the second one has that additive effect, and we end up seeing longer term results with that. And so that's usually why we pair two of them together as opposed to just doing one. Now, one of the biggest things that I talk with my patients about who have a past history of traumatic experiences or things that they have not worked through in the past is it is absolutely crucial to work with a qualified therapist or counselor in order to actually address those underlying issues that are resulting in the expression of the sympathetic nervous system. So whether that's through triggers or things like that. And the reason for that is because the stellate ganglion block in and of itself is not a curative treatment. There are some patients where if we do serial stellate ganglion blocks over time, what we see is their, let's say their generalized anxiety, goes from a 7 out of 10, and maybe after 6 to 9 months, they're kind of down to maybe a 5 out of 10 at baseline. However, I mean, that is a minor reduction, and sometimes it's not even clinically significant. The real magic with the stellate ganglion block and PTSD is that it allows patients the opportunity to address the hard stuff in their counseling sessions, in their therapy sessions, without having really large triggers. And so we always recommend and pair these stellate ganglion blocks with some form of counseling and try to include things like cognitive behavioral therapy or EMDR or anything that actually tries to address this old traumatic experience and helps the patient to work through it. And so normally what would happen without the stellate ganglion block is, let's say an easy example to give is a vet who gets triggered with fireworks or talking about a specific incident from when they were deployed that had to do with an IED. And so if that person goes back to talk about that experience, they get a huge outflowing of sympathetic nervous system activity. So adrenaline, cortisol, all this stuff just starts flowing, and it becomes difficult for the brain to disconnect to say that's in the past. Now with the stellate ganglion block, what happens is that connection has been dampened. And so when they start to talk about it, or when they are triggered from that event, whether that's fireworks or the sound of a car accident or something, then we see a big reduction in that sympathetic outflow with that triggering event. And over time, that re-exposure with that dampened sympathetic nervous system helps to train the body that you're safe, You are safe. This is not happening again. And I don't have to dump out a whole bunch of adrenaline, cortisol, and other things to protect you and keep you alive. You are safe. And so that's where the true magic in the stellate ganglion block lies for PTSD, anxiety, and trauma, things like that, is pairing these injections with the hard work of therapy, counseling, and that type of stuff. And so that is going to be our first procedure for the day. And so I'm going to, just like a lot of my procedures, I always review the anatomy, the technique, just anything. I'll look to see if there's new research articles available, but I'm always trying to stay on top of that aspect of this art and this medicine, is how do we do this? Why do we do this? What complications can arise? How do we mitigate them? What do we do about that? And just really try to step my game up. So I hope you're all having a great day so far.